Richard Feynman once said when talking to one of his very talented friends. He said that when I look at this rose on this table, this coffee table between us as we have lunch, the fact that I understand the biochemistry of photosynthesis, and that there's a specific range of wavelengths of photons of light that this plant doesn't absorb, and by virtue of that it reflects it back towards my eye, making it green, doesn't lessen, but in fact deepens my sense of wonder and awe and appreciation of its beauty. So with that, I'd like to continue in that vein of thought.
If you guys are as
inspired, and I don't know, you feel like you're a little bit more in tune with the world when you understand that, you know, everyday objects that we see dried and packaged, neatly separated, like black pepper and coffee and saffron and these nuts that you don't usually get in the store. And it's so far removed from their natural environment, the natural environment they grew up in. I think it adds depth and just a sense of overall better comprehension of the world. Just like when you realize what's on your plate, how it got there. And I'm addicted to meat, but I've been avoiding at all costs, almost, that's a bold statement, eating pigs and cows, just partly for sanitary reasons because of how poorly they're raised, but also ethically, I don't see their lives being the least bit satisfactory. It's pretty harsh how they, but this isn't to get all bogged down in the misery of the world, but I think looking at things like this give us a little better comprehension, better understanding of just how the world works, and how many people must have jobs to get you your cup of coffee if you're listening to this from the first world. But the Japanese say, you have three faces. And any Japanese out there, please, I'd be curious if this is, in fact, a cultural artifact of yours. The first face you show to the world. The second face you show to your close friends and your family. And the third face you never show to anyone. It is the truest reflection of who you really are. That's an astute observation. Oh, and speaking of elephants can die of a broken heart if a mate dies. They'll actually refuse to eat and will lay down shedding tears until they starve. I honestly did not realize elephants can cry. I mean, it's an evolutionary it's an evolved behavior, I suppose, but has evolutionary benefits. But that elephants can cry due to a loss of a loved one. It's beautiful. Speaking of beauty, according to psychologists, coloring is the best alternative to meditation. Coloring allows to unlock your creative potential. Perhaps more important, it helps relieve tension and anxiety. It also unlocks memories of childhood and simpler times. You know, it makes me, I've been going back and, just trying to figure out what it is, other than is really pleasant. Deep style of speaking and just very naturally very calm and slowly paced intonation. I've been wondering why I enjoy his drawing. drawing videos so much. He had this drawing video the other day for anyone who hasn't seen it. I'd highly recommend if you think you might be interested in watching someone very expertly and very smoothly and gracefully and just draw and slowly narrate what he's doing. And perhaps this reason right here is exactly what I really, really get out of it, is the connection to simpler times. But of course, I think this is truer than anything right here, is that you need a face. Perhaps the face you don't ever show anyone needs to retain a little bit of that childlike awe of the world. Or else we're not going to, you'll become too overly cynical and you won't. You won't be able to easily access the optimism and cheerfulness, and perhaps you will ignore beauty if it's right in front of your face even. Yeah, Asmartica. His videos are expertly simple, and perhaps that's one of the facets of ASMR, is just looking at someone do something very, very skillfully, so skillfully, in fact, that they make it look much easier than it is. He has a way about drawing that makes just goosebumps pop up on my arms. But it does, I think, really connect it with my childhood. I used to love to draw, so perhaps I should start trying to do that as well, because I like it so much. Age 12, Simon Cowell was arrested for hijacking a bus with a toy gun. He was arrested for hijacking a bus with a toy gun. So clearly he had a high degree of, or a low degree of agreeableness. He was not willing, he was not afraid to rub people the wrong way, to do what he wanted. And speaking of not afraid, I think it's immensely easier to feel mentally, physically, and in your general perspective more secure in your environment and in your social status, and like you have a cushion when you fail at a project if you already start from a relatively wealthy family, like Steve Jobs and Steve Wozniak did. However, nonetheless, they still stuck their neck out and put in countless man hours, really just went throttle to the floor, full throttle. All in to pursue their dream of starting a quality, user-friendly, domestically driven computer company. And it is nonetheless inspiring. Clearly they were intelligent people, but clearly they were not going to be destitute and starved to death if they had failed their business opportunity. But what's inspiring to me about this story is that although people in that spectrum, it's a blessing that our current state isn't, they weren't discouraged from starting their own company in the way democracy works. And I don't at all want to get political, mainly because I'm just too ignorant about it, but I think it's quite promising that we have so much relative wealth. I think I heard that 100 years ago, even Americans lived on, and this is adjusted for inflation, less than $1 a day. So that's a pretty astounding, seriously staggering fact that worldwide, I think it's very uplifting and positive for all those cynical people who only, for whatever reason, choose to look at the more dismal facts about the world, which are in plenitude, you know, are certainly in abundant supply. But it's worthwhile, I think, to take a look at some of the more uplifting facts, and that's what I wanted to make this video a little bit about. Because look at what one person did, or two people, but really it was a seed that grew from this to this massive structure right here. I don't know, it's just encouraging to know that in our lives, even if we might backtrack some days, overall, you want to head towards the right trajectory, and once you get your mind made up on a goal, I think it's incredibly astounding what anybody is capable of. At least anybody choosing to watch a facts ASMR video over a what's in my purse, perhaps makeup roleplay. Nothing wrong with that, but I think that you need to give yourself more credit than you probably do. And I really try to tell myself that sometimes. I think we're all capable of astounding things. Just like Mozart. Although he was, of course, an exception above most. He disliked a performer named Adriano Ferraris. Maybe I gotta roll my R there. Ferraris. Del Bene Bene. So, knowing her tendency to drop her chin on low notes and throw back her head on high ones, Mozart actually wrote a song with constant leaps from low to high in order to make her head bob like a chicken on stage. Mozart. What a petty individual. A grandly genius individual man, but that was a pretty petty act. Although I'm sure it was worth a few good laughs. Meet the Japanese dwarf flying squirrel. They're probably the cutest animals on Earth. Yeah, they actually are. Okay. Oh, Bear Grylls. In 96, Bear Grylls broke his back. Holy shit. After falling 16,000 feet due to a ripped parachute. And 2 years later, he climbed the summit of Mount Everest. That's cool. And once again, I think human individuals, human beings, were clearly descended from the best of the best. You know, I mean, 10,000, 100,000 years ago, 1 million years ago, survival of the fittest, the principle of merely enduring the extremely harsh reality. must have certainly weeded out many of the weakest, so you gotta give yourself again more credit. Guys, girls out there, you're capable of astounding things. And one who knows and who has a why can bear almost anyhow. Famous quote by Nietzsche. George Washington, speaking of which, is the only U.S. president, the first, in fact, and only to have received 100% of the electoral votes. Naturally, that's a artifact of the solidity and unity caused by an extremely tribal conflict between the U.S., newly founded U.S., and the overly tyrannical, taxing British government. And I think, to his credit, although I know very little about him, maybe there was a deeper motivation there, but he chose to give up, willfully give up, his essential open road to a dictatorship of the U.S. and thereby actually had rippling repercussions for generations that we, in the sense that modern politicians have his example, he's his ideal to not unnecessarily wield excessive force and power, and actually have the higher order of being to step down and pave the way for a democracy. So, or at least a relative democracy, more democratic than most. In Guinea's capital, poor children walk for miles to do their homework in the airport parking lot. It's one of the few places in the city where the lights are always on. That really makes you, makes me, learning facts like that kind of stimulates the back of my head to just keep going. When you have it, I'm already way ahead of the curve. If I don't make something of my life, then I'm doing them a disservice. When you remember a past event, you're actually remembering the last time you remembered it, not the event itself. I think that's... Oh man, these are all so, so good. I love, obviously, the psychology of it all. I think... the concept of your psyche being in tune with the reality, and you feel, when you're acting in such a way that you're kind of lying about the reality that you know, or even kind of unconsciously only know, your body does feel, you don't feel like you're together, your spine doesn't feel strong, you don't feel, you don't feel like being vocal about the way you're living, and I think constantly, what's most real for you is, in fact, your experiences, and second to that is your memories of those experiences. So if you lie, the next time you think about what you've done, a lie is in the recent past and is very, very much active in your brain, your consciousness, your circuitry. And even though it might behoove you to lie, it might benefit you to lie in the short term, maybe in the next hour, to avoid doing something, or even in the next week, in a year, you'll remember that you weren't truthful, and you'll wonder why other people have lied to you. You'll recognize that long term it's not a profitable game for either you, yourself, your family, or consequently the world, which is made up of a bunch of selves and families and tribes. I think being truthful is, in fact, the best long-term solution. Again. A photographer is approached by a baby deer and a baby wolf while they're out in the field. Oh, goodness. That is cute overload. That is, why is that so pleasurable to watch? That just puts a big old grin on my face. That's so beautiful. Speculation here. Our entire universe is probably in a tiny glass jar somewhere, placed on a shelf in an alien's child's room. As a science fair project that got a C minus. This is beautiful. Look at that. An abandoned temple in a Cambodian jungle. Psychologists say that the person who tries to keep everyone happy often ends up feeling the loneliest. I think trying to keep people happy can only be accomplished after you know who you are and what you're striving for. And of course, do it. But it's not necessarily a bad goal, per se. Next time you want to give up, think of Jeff Bezos, the billionaire, multi-billionaire, just 20 years ago. Just think of that. You could be in a ditch, next to dead, or you could be a billionaire in 20 years. Have a goal and go for it. You guys can. We all have so much more to offer than we currently are, for the most part. I know, at least, I do. I gotta tell myself. Honestly, I wonder if I'd be making these videos just for myself if I had no audience. Oh, that's funny. So we have a picture of a diver, a scuba diver, with a camera. The lack of depth perception in this two-dimensional picture makes it hard to tell exactly how large the shark is, but it's at least would say it's at least 10 feet, probably more like 15. It says this is the most dangerous animal in the world, responsible for millions of deaths every year. By its side, a great white shark swims peacefully. Okay, for Google, if a Google employee dies, the company pays half of their salary to their partner for 10 years and gives $1,000 a month to any children until they turn 19. Wow. The head of HR says it's part of the company's goal to do right by their employees. Giant tarantulas keep tiny frogs as pets. Insects will eat the burrowing tarantula's eggs, so the spiders protect the frogs from predators. In return, the frogs eat the insects. No. Oh my god, this is a brilliant note to end on. Scientists have developed a filled with oxygen, which can be injected in the bloodstream. And with itself, we can live without breathing. I would have to fact check that. That's pretty astounding. Oh, man. So apparently, they're playing the song Titanic. all the kind words and feedback and connection we kind of have, the fact that you're choosing to watch this means that there is something. Wow, look at that. Growing out of the plumbing. There is something to all this. You know, we all desire meaning in life, and I think the people we choose to forge connections with gives us that. But you can't have a meaningful relationship unless you are yourself doing something that makes life worth living and overcoming obstacles, and we all need other people to help us do that. And so in a way, I hope that looks like the other one. Wow, that's very beautiful. Very eerie, but beautiful. Yeah, I don't know, in a way I just feel like we are all doing our little part. In the ASMR community, for sure. And hopefully on my video specifically, that help mitigate the cynicism of the world and kind of bathe in the beauty that our world has to offer for just a few minutes at a time. Life isn't always great, but it's not how many times you can get hit, it's how many times you can get hit and still get back up and still try, aim to pursue your goal. And I think educating yourself and learning how to communicate with other people in a respectful dialogue and maintaining a sense of awe and wonder for the world we live in, because we don't know, and acknowledging the limits of your intelligence and knowledge and experience. Everybody has a different experience in life. I think to me that's where the meaning lies when we communicate with one another. We compare notes. And I very much appreciate that you guys don't reject mine and find my notes somewhat entertaining to watch and listen to. And I hope you get something out of what I do here. And speaking of getting something out of what I do, I'm just immensely grateful for all my supporters out there. So I just wanted to quickly say thank you once again to Sean McQueen. I really appreciate that donation, man. You're so kind. All of you who choose to donate, it blows my mind, but I'm so, I humbly accept it. I'm so grateful, and I don't know. I don't want to sound too, formal, but I don't know what else to say. I gotta get some better words for next shout-outs, but I don't know. I really am. It makes me feel like I'm doing something right, and it's not perfect, and I should keep improving my quality, but I shouldn't give it up. I don't know. Maybe I should. But for now, the support of Tim, Steve C, Jody, Tristan, Ryan, Sandy, and Milena. Milena, thank you so much. It's keeping me encouraged. And what's motivating me to not stop is all my Patreon supporters as well, especially you new ones, Sander with an X, Katie, and Alexander, Dylan, Dale. It's just, it's a good feeling that you guys are getting something out of what I do. And of course, Potato Launch, Hardyak, Cameron, Simon, Ella, Kieran, Sean, Antoine, and Eric C. Debbie, thank you so much. Mark, Matthias, Joshua, and Andy. I don't have any words. I'm so grateful. I just want to show my gratitude and appreciation of your support. I hope you all have a wonderful night. And I hope tomorrow's a little bit better than yesterday was. Because over 20 years, as you can see, you can turn a house into a formidable castle, I guess. I didn't want to say anything like tyrannical, like empire, but you can turn a house into a home and a castle with tables large enough to invite those closest and dearest to you and share in those good memories that are indeed finite. We're only gonna spend so many hours with those that you love in life, whether it's 10,000 or whether it's only 40, you know, there is a finite number to it. So let's appreciate each other and go out and be the best people we can be, so that we encourage others and ourselves at the same time. And maybe, just maybe, this world will be a better place you've walked through it. Good night, guys.